Hello everybody, today we are going to see theorem, okay, which is depend on the AAS bracket, angle side, okay. So here today's concept is angle side, that is AAS criterion of congruence. So we are going to study about this condition, okay. See here, statement is given, that is theorem number 1. From this concept, theorem number 1 is, if AB two angles and a non-included side of one triangle are equal to the corresponding angles and side of another triangle, then the two triangles are congruent. Okay. So first we will see this statement and the given figures. Okay. We will see, that is, if any two angles and a non-included side of one triangle, ASA we have seen two angles and included side, but here two angles and non-included side, which is not included by the two angles. So like that condition is there, that time how to show the triangles are congruent, that we are going to see with the help of this theorem. Okay, so first, any two angles and non-included side of one triangle are equal to the corresponding angles and side of another triangle, then the triangles are congruent. Here see, it is given that angle A is equal to angle D, angle B is equal to angle E according to the given statement, and BC, which is not included by these two angles, angle A and angle B, BC is equal to EF. EF is also not included by D and E, angle D and E, okay, which is not included. So here AAS, angle side, okay, but directly we cannot use AAS bracket. Okay, so here this we are going to use ASA, angle side angle, which we have learned, angle side angle criteria we are going to use. Okay, so how to show that triangles are congruent, that we are going to see. Okay, so first, as usual in theorem, we are going to write given. What is given here? Angle in triangle ABC, triangle ABC and triangle DEF. What is given? Angle A is equal to angle B. And what is given? Angle B is equal to angle E. B and E are equal, because two angles are equal, given it is. And non included side BC. BC is equal to EF. These things are given. Okay. So now here we are going to use. Now prove, what we have to prove? To prove triangles are congruent. This triangle ABC from congruent triangle DEF. That is our target. Triangle ABC congruent triangle DEF. Okay. Just now I told you we are going to use angle side angle. ASA criteria. ASA criteria. But here two angles are given. And this side AB is AB and DE. They have not told us anything, AB and DE are equal. So, if I am going to use here angle side angle property or condition, then I must have two angles and one side, included side, should be equal to the two angles and included side. Okay, so see here how to do that. Now, proof in triangle ABC and triangle DEF. We are going to use these two triangles because we are going to show triangles are congruent. Now what is given? See, angle A is equal to angle D, which is given. Again, what is given? Second, angle B is equal to angle E. This is also given. Okay. We will say this is first one and this is second. Okay. Now see, suppose I will do an addition. We know the property, angle sum property of triangle. Angle sum property of triangle, what is? Angle A plus B plus C is equal to 180. The sum of three angles of any triangle is always 180. So if I want to do here addition, angle A plus B, what is the value of A plus B? Okay, what will be the value of A plus B? So see here carefully, I am showing here angle. Suppose I am taking this angle A plus angle B plus angle C is equal to 180 degree. Okay, if I want angle A plus B, what is the value of angle A plus B? A plus B is equal to 180 minus angle C. Or plus C will do that same. It will be subtracted from 180. Okay, same thing here. Angle, this is first thing, this is second thing I am taking here. Angle D plus angle E plus angle F is equal to 180. Angles of property. Now, angle B plus E, suppose I will keep here angle D plus angle E is equal to 180 minus angle F. Minus angle F. Okay, why I am showing this? Because now we are going to do addition of this. Okay, so here I am taking that my adding. And first and second, 1 and 2, by adding 1 and 2. That is angle A plus LHS in LHS angle B is equal to angle D plus angle E. Okay, angle A plus B is equal to angle D plus E. Okay, it is going to remain same. So, is equal to sign will be constant. Okay, so now A plus B, A plus B, what I told you, 180 minus angle C, 180 minus angle C. So, that I am keeping on here. Angle A plus B is equal to 180 minus angle C. Why 180 minus angle minus C? Because we have taken here angles of property of triangle. Okay, so here I am replacing 180 minus angle C is equal to B plus E. Angle B plus E is equal to 180 minus angle F. 180 minus angle F. Okay, so now here see 180 we can cancel from both the sides. Okay, so what is going to remain? Minus angle C, minus angle A. So minus minus can be cancelled. So what is going to remain finally? Angle C is equal to angle F. Angle C is equal to angle F. Okay, so third one angle, this third one angle is also now equal. Third one angle is also equal. Okay, now which means we have? We have all the three angles of this triangle, triangle ABC, are equal to the corresponding angles of triangle DEF. All the three angles and one side they have proposed. Now it is possible to use here angles side angle property. How? See again. Now we have C and F are equal. Angle B and angle E are already this given equal. And BC and EF are equal. BC and EF are equal. So two angles and included side of angle ABC are equal to the two angles and included side of angle DEF. So by ASA criteria we can say both the triangles are congruent. Both the triangles are congruent. Okay. So that what we are going to write now here in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, angle B is equal to angle E. Why? Given BC is equal to EF. BC is equal to EF, that is also given, and ACB or angle C is equal to angle F. Why? This is, we will say here, this is hurdle. Okay, so here we can say from 3 we can say this is angle C is equal to angle F. Okay, so now we can say triangle ABC congruent triangle DEF. DEF by ASA. Okay, by ASA criteria. By ASA criteria, both the triangles are congruent. Understood? Here means what we can say, if two angles and non-included side of one triangle are equal to the corresponding angles and non-included side of another triangle, that time also both the triangles are congruent by AAS criteria. By AAS criteria we can use. Understood? So this is proof we have seen with the help of ASA criteria. Got it everybody? So what we have done here, you see this is important. So once again, given things we have mentioned, two triangle ABC and DEF are congruent. Okay, then what we have said, in triangle ABC and triangle DEF, angle A is equal to D, B is equal to E, that is given. We have done addition of both. Okay, so after addition we got आपको राइट इट्स ए प्लस बी डी प्लस डी प्लस ई. सो ए प्लस बी इज इक्वल टू वी हैव डन दिस एंगल सम प्रॉपर्टी. ए प्लस बी वैल्यू वी कैन पुट हियर एंड आल्सो बी प्लस ई. सो 180 विल बी कैंसिल. एंगल सी एंड एंगल ए आर इक्वल. थ्री एंगल्स ऑफ दिस ट्रायंगल एंड थ्री एंगल्स ऑफ करस्पोंडिंग ट्रायंगल आर इक्वल एंड वन साइड इज इवन. सो अगेन वी हैव टेकन बार ए से क्राइटेरिया ट्रायंगल्स आर कॉमन. ओके here or say theorem number 2 is if two angles of a triangle are equal then sides opposite to them are equal. Okay, if two angles of a triangle are equal, here triangle ABC is given, two angles are equal, so we will say here triangle B and angle C are equal. Two angles of a triangle are equal, then sides opposite to them are equal. Sides opposite to them is here we have to show AB and AC are equal. Okay, so first as usual we need to write given. Okay, triangle ABC is given. Triangle ABC is given and two angles of a triangle are equal. So here we can say angle B is equal to angle C. This is given. Now what we have to show, then sides opposite to them are equal. This 2, 2, 2, 2. Sides opposite to them means we have to show here AB is equal to AC. This is our target that we have to show. Okay. So now here directly we cannot show. If I am going to use any criteria, then I must get there two triangles. Okay. Then I will show both the triangles are congruent and further things we can write. But here only one triangle is needed. So we need to convert this into two triangles. Okay, so for that we need to do some construction here. So I can take bisector of angle A. Okay, we have to do construction in such a way where I will get bisector of angle A and it will meet BC. Okay, if we meet BC at a point, we will say that point is D. Bisector of angle A is this angle and this angle. That is BAD and CAD are equal. Like that construction we have to do. So now, construction also we need to mention here. Construct bisector of angle A. Okay, it will meet side BC at point B. Okay, so we have the construction. Now we have two triangles. Okay, so now we will see which criteria how to explain both the triangles are congruent. Okay, if both the triangles are congruent, then we can say AB is equal to AC. AB is equal to AC by CPCD. But here important, we have to put both the triangles are congruent. And now it is very easy. Okay. So see here carefully, what is given? ABD. I am talking about two triangles. ABD and ACD. Okay. We are thinking about two triangles now. Angle ABD is equal to angle ACD. Why? Because it is given. It is given here. B equals to C. Okay. Now, what we can say, BAD is this angle, BAD is equal to CAD. Why? What is the reason? By construction, because like that only construction we have done, so these two triangles are congruent. And third thing, AD is equal to AD, because that is the common side of both the triangles. Okay, so now we can say AAS, angle, angle, side, both the triangles are congruent. If both the triangles are congruent, we can say AB is equal to AC. Okay, so this is simple rule. So before starting, we must have a proper plan how to prove a given theorem or given sum, which is like a theorem, how to give proof. Okay, so that is important. So that plan we must have. We need to think about that first and then we have to remember it. Okay, so now I am taking the proof. Okay, first in triangle ABD and triangle ACD. ACD. Okay. What is angle ABD? Angle ABD is equals to angle ACD. ACD. Why? This is given. Okay. Now BAD angle BAD is equals to angle CAD. CAD. Why? What is the reason? Why construction? Like that construction we have. Okay. And 30 AD is equals to AD because AD is the common side for both the triangles. So we can say AD is equals to AD. Okay. So now we can say here triangle ABD. Triangle ABD. Congruent triangle ACD by AAS. Angle side. Okay, side is different. Why? Because this is not included itself. That's not we have seen theorem. Okay, depend on that theorem, we can say two angles corresponding to are equal and included, which is not included itself. Sorry, that time also triangles are congruent. So by AAS criteria, both the triangles are congruent. If both the triangles are congruent, corresponding sides are equal, so we can say AB is equal to AB is equal to AC by CBCD, corresponding parts of congruent triangles. Okay. Okay. See here theorem number 3 is. This is theorem number 3. What is given? See, statement: if the altitude from one vertex of a triangle bisects the opposite side, then the triangle is isosceles. Okay, we have to prove triangle isosceles. See once again: if the altitude from vertex of a triangle, altitude is not from point A, that is vertex A on side BC. It's altitude, so definitely this is 90 degrees. ADB and ADC both are right angle. Okay, if altitude from one vertex of a triangle bisects the opposite side means by opposite side is BC, it bisected, so it is BD is equal to CD, that is one, then the triangle is isosceles. So you have to prove that triangle is ABC is isosceles. Okay, so first whatever given things are there. So given, what is given? Triangle ABC. AD is altitude. Okay, which is drawn from point A on BC. Then what is given? Of triangle bisect the opposite side. Bisect the opposite side is BD is equals to CD. These things are given. Now to prove. What we have to do here? Then the triangle is isosceles. Triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. What is the property of isosceles triangle? When AB two sides are equal, that time that triangle is isosceles triangle. Means here about triangle ABC, we need to show that angle AB is equals to AC. Sorry, side AB is equals to side AC. Okay. If we are able to prove AB and AC are equal, then triangle ABC is isosceles triangle. Okay. So here we can write AB is equals to AC. This is our target. If this we can prove, we can say triangle ABC is isosceles triangle. Okay. So this proof is very simple. So here see, first we will discuss about this and then we will give on the paper. What is given? See, if we are thinking about triangle ABD and triangle ACD, we will prove that two triangles are congruent, both the triangles are congruent. So here AD is the common side. AD is common side for both the triangles. That is one thing we have. ADB is equal to ADC, both 90 degree because this is altitude and altitude is the altitude is always perpendicular to the base. So this is 90 degree, this is 90 degree, and BD is equal to CD, which is given. So by side angle side, by SAS, two triangles are congruent, both the triangles are congruent, If angles are congruent, we can say AB is equal to AC by CP, CP. If AB is equal to AC, then triangle ABC is isosceles. So very simple proof. So now I am taking that here. Proof. Here proof. And proof. In triangle ABC, ABD, and triangle ACD. We can see here AD is equals to AD, which is common for both the triangles. AD is common for both the triangles. Then we can say angle ADB, ADB is equals to angle ADC, both 90 degree. So they are equal. And BD, third one is BD is equals to CD. That is given. BD and CD, why equal? Because that is given. Okay. So by side angle sets, SAS criteria, you can say triangle ABD congruent triangle ACD by SAS criteria, by side angle set. Okay. Side angle set, both the triangles are congruent. If both the triangles are congruent, then we can say AB is equals to AC. Why? By CP, CD, corresponding parts of congruent triangle. Okay. If AB and AC are equal, AB and AC are equal, then we can say triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. Okay. Triangle ABC is an isosceles triangle. Okay. So today we have seen three theorems. So you have to understand all the three theorems, because theorems are important. Then read all the paper, write down and do practice. Okay. So today's your work is three theorems you have to solve by your own. First you see here, understand, and then solve by your own in your work. Thank you.